I'm just going to switch the mic on while I'm doing this, because it seems a bit silly just to leave the quiet stream. How's everyone doing? Oh, hey, Andres. Got your computer up and running yet? Heck yeah. Oh, slippery duck, Kara. Ah, problems with the audio driver. Fantastic. Okay, that's all the self-promotion out of the way. So, can everyone see everything okay? Alrighty, I'm just gonna put performance mode so I don't have to see my face, which is just weird. Oh, hey, Sugar. Snaps. And Amanda. Hope you're both doing well. Ice cream is always a good choice. Right, so, first things first, a bit of promo. As I've said a few times before, Ridley said he'd hate watching Metroid Other M if he reached 200 followers, and well, that's happened. And I'll be in the stream to make it tolerable and or worse by spamming puns. So yep, that's happening on the 17th at 2 p.m. That's Thursday the 17th, so a week this Thursday. And I'll be at 2 p.m. GMT / UTC plus zero, which for reference, I started at 6 o'clock, which is 4 hours before. Is it worth getting up at 6 a.m? Well, I have to be up at 4 for my day job, so make of that what you will. In any case, we now have basically everything apart from the final few upgrades. So we are going to, what's the Phazon mines? Just take a look around. Is there anything here I can think of? I'm fairly certain. Oh yeah, there's something in the root at the top of the root cave. I'd like to see what that is. Where am I currently? Okay, so the root cave is in the Talanova world. No, I'm just approaching the Omega Pirate. so Talanobu World East or South, I know one of those takes me there. East, and that's Talanobu World South. Okay, so I'm going to go. Just going to go to the south one because it looks like there's something there as well. Oh, that's good, Amanda. I myself am just trying to sort out my last dose of the anti-testosterone implants I get before I have surgery, which of course means I won't need them. Because normally I have 3 month ones and I just need a 1 month one. And my GP is a bit of a pain in the arse about that. I need to sort it out sooner rather than later. So this is the Great Tree Hall. Where's this door? Alright, I believe... Just a missile upgrade, but it'll do. Okay. What else we got? Okay, so Chosen Ruins East takes me here. That's probably the quickest way. So yeah, in a way, the plasma and the ice beam are sort of opposites. So the ice beam's very slow and the plasma's very fast but has short range. Don't know why I felt that was the best moment to mention that, but there's a random bit of trivia for you. And we're just going to save so I don't lose that missile upgrade. Rhyme completely unintentional. Alright. Another thing, I just remembered. See if this works in OBS. Yes. Okay, so Twitch has a new system called the prediction. New thing called predictions. And basically it means I can I just think of a prediction, then give two outcomes. Everyone gets to invest a few points to vote in each outcome. And if you guess the winning, well, if you get it, you don't guess the correct one, you lose your points. If you get it right, you get to keep a share of the points from the losing option. So we are going to tell you what, let's do something simple, because I did a poll and that said TSAMR. So we'll do something tea themed. What flavour tea am I drinking? Okay, so these are both flavours of tea I've Okay, so that prediction's live. They're both flavours of tea I've drank, but only one of them is what's in this mug. So, feel free to guess which one. And in 5 minutes, we'll know the results. I haven't really drunk Earl Grey very often. Okay, last chance to call it. It's on the clock. Must be showing things weird for me. Okay. This is the first time I've done it, so I'm not quite sure what it looks like. Ah, fair enough. Thank you. Well, we'll see what the prediction looks like when we call it. And if this goes well and I get to the Omega Pirate, I'll probably do one for the, Oh, that's fair enough. Oh yeah, yeah, I see it now. Okay, there's 30 points in the pool and everything to play for. Okay, which way am I going? Dead ahead. Oh, hey, Machine Lord Zero. Thanks for the raid. How are you doing this evening? If you want to have a go, we're just doing the channel's first ever prediction. If you want to hop in there before the timer runs out in 30 seconds. Well, I'm the opposite of tired. I don't think it's still in the absence of tiredness, I'm just sort of, Okay, keep forgetting this is up here. Oops. What, you're already going to bed then? Okay, so I'm gonna climb up here. Finished yet? It's closed. Manage request queue. Okay, looks like I need to open Firefox for that. Such is life. Okay, it's being slow, so we shall keep playing. Ow. Okay, that's what I get for not looking. Alright, let's see. Random trivia. Requests. Okay, can't see anything there. Sorry about this, I assure you everyone this will go a bit more smoothly in future. Ooh. Ice cream with cookie dough. Very nice indeed. Any particular recipe or? I think I had a widget for the prediction. Stream health. Oh, that's handy. Oh, excellent. Here we are. Choose prediction outcome. Okay, so the answer was, of course, red bush spiced. So well done to everyone who chose that. Everyone who did will be winning 30 channel points. And thank you for participating. Sorry about that, Kara. Remember, kids, don't gamble. Unless, of course, on Bisected Brioche's stream, because that's different because I say so. Okay, so. It's wonderful. Okay, anything up here? Oh yeah, that's a random outclove that had a missile upgrade in it. We have another missile upgrade. Lovely stuff. So yeah, feel free to make any suggestions for predictions there. Because if there's one thing I absolutely should be doing, this is encouraging you all to gamble. Possibly even to proctor. In any case, what's the most efficient way to get back to the Phazon mines? Oh yeah, that reminds me. Wonder where I get the ice spreader. Okay, so we need to go back to Metroid Quarantine in the second level. South. and I could have sworn there was a shortcut to, Phazon mines. Somewhere. Well, anyway, let's... get back to where we were before. So yeah, red bush tea. Yeah, if anyone didn't know, it's literally from the red bush. Not exactly a particularly mysterious name, but it's very similar to black tea, but it's caffeine free and tastes slightly sweeter. And I remember. That takes me to the chosen ruins east. Come on, there must be a faster way to get to the So what I need to do is, I need to go choose those rooms far away off. Ow. No, I don't need to go by way about, that's completely the wrong route. Chozo ruins. Let's go back. It chose over in south. also so good at navigating maps. Sorry about all that, now I know where I'm going. Can't be friends right now. Traversal mechanics, ladies, gents, and anyone who knows better. Okay, so that's left immediately. Ghosts are going to attack, but it doesn't matter because I'm just going to run past them. Severus taught everyone. If you don't want to deal with ghosts, you can just run away from him. And we're back where we began this stream. Drop more core bombs. Open for me. Thank you. Okay, this has been quite a quiet stream, so let's get back to the action. So, how's everyone been enjoying Metroid Prime anyway? You love it. It's one of my favourite games of all time for a reason. Although that reason is obviously boils down to personal preference. I mean, objectively speaking, Prime 2 is a better game. But, you know, because it's obviously the... first game in the, well, not the first game in the series, but the first game. The second, well, the sequel just doesn't have the same oomph. Oh, you never got the plasma beam. Ah, that's fair enough. To be honest, this sort of last part of the game is a bit, yeah. Just because you, yeah, after this next boss, it basically turns into sort of a scavenger hunt around the level map to find the 12 markers to unlock the final area. But for reasons I will explain, will become quite obvious, it's very worth getting that last upgrade first. The fire beam is high damage at close range. And it also melts ice. so it's good for any enemy that's weak against fire, because in addition to doing heavy damage, it also does damage over time. Yep, fire causes DPS. And the electricity also, well, each beam also has its own sort of work in aiming at things. So like the wave beam has a slight homing quality to it. The power beam is the fastest. The arse beam is slow. But very damaging. And the plasma beam is fast and damaging, but has poor range. It's basically a shotgun. From a distance, it can do quite a bit of damage. Anywho, obviously, I've unlocked a shortcut in this part. Oh yeah, a Metroid RPG would be quite interesting, actually. Although, I don't know who you'd actually be able to play as, since Samus is a very sort of lone operative sort of character. Sort of love how this bit is literally floating around in the waste disposable. Physics underwater are kind of weird because if you aren't in an area that lets you bounce, it actually sort of acts as if it hits a, you just hit a wall. So we're back in the mines. Okay, Amanda redeemed. Random trivia. Oh, modern day bounty hunters work as basically enforcement agents for bail bond agencies in the US. They don't actually have any legal. Well, they have basically have the legal power to execute a warrant for someone who skipped on bail and nothing else. Okay, so from here. Area now. Where do I want to go from here? seems to drop down to the second level. Okay, I'm gonna drop down all the way to the first. No matter. Do you consider that sufficient for your trivia, Amanda? Where the why, Kara, why? Okay, so Kara's of course redeemed any objections lady mode, aka Other M mode, in which you all take the role of Adam Malkovich, and I must ask permission from the chat to use anything. So, without further ado. Okay, Google, give me a 10-minute timer. Okay, Google, give me a 10-minute timer. Okay, Google, give me a 10-minute timer.
Okay, 10 minutes, starting.
There we go. Okay, 10 minutes begin. Okay. So I don't need anything to drop down here. Alright, permission to use the ice beam to open this door. Thank you, Kara. And yeah, don't worry about that. Sorry, I should have asked permission to use the wave beam. Sorry, I'll do better. Okay, permission to use the ice beam on this door. Hey QWERTY, you arrived just in time for Other M mode. Okay, permission to use the ice beam to open this door, please. Pretty please with a cherry on top. I don't want to be stuck here. Okay, so I see what you did there, Amanda, because I am so cool. And we're just going down the mine.
It's a mine.
Permission to use the ice beam on this door. Thank you very much. Oh, come on. Okay, permission to use the wave beam on the door ahead. Thank you, QWERTY. Okay, so... permission to use the ice beam. Okay, permission to use the thermal visor. Please. I'm just going to assume I still have permission to use the ice beam in that door. Permission to use morph ball to get through this tunnel. Okay, morph at will, thank you, Kara. I don't know who Will is, but I'll morph at them. Okay, permission to power bomb this. I should be asking permission to drink tea. No, that's not an ability. Okay, power on. And permission to ice beam this door. Yep, that is a deadly bomb. You think with my levels in the Brit class, drinking tea counts as a basic action? Well, I'm nothing but basic. Oh. Okay, I'm gonna just scan this guy before we continue. A new creature's entry has been downloaded to your logbook. Morphology, Plasma Trooper. Space pirate armed with plasma beam technology. Space pirates have reverse engineered several of your weapons, including the plasma beam floor, and the design makes these pirates vulnerable to their own weapon system. These weapons are inferior to your chosen designed originals, but still quite potent. Whew. Okay, permission to use the plasma beam to end this guy. And the wave beam on the other. Please, they're invulnerable to everything else. Thank you. Oh, and the ice beam. Okay, so theoretically I could drop into the Phazon down here and take this entry. But I very much doubt it would be a good idea. Namely because it's drained pretty much all of my health just landing in it. Yeah, I agree, the background noise is pretty creepy. Okay, you've allowed me to use ice. Where is it? Ah. Okay, this is where I die. Find my way around. Which way am I going? Oh yep, there's something up the top of this. Permission to use morph ball. Hey Nessie, how you doing? You're just in time for the last 30 seconds of Other M mode. Okay, well, I'm curling into a ball. Ah. Mission to use morph ball bomb. Out of time for Other M mode, so I can do that with impunity. Okay, that's the end of Other M mode. Thank you everyone for participating. Basically, it's partially a joke about Metroid Other M being ridiculous, but also, it's just a way for the chat to sort of mess with me. Just makes the whole game a bit more fun at frantic moments. It gets really fun when the chat gets sadistic enough to that someone drops it right at the end. Doing that. Okay, that's the way I need to go. Oh no. Okay, so what I need to do here. It basically depends on what I might do is I might make it shorter but allow it multiple times per stream just so everyone gets a chance to sort of pick a really good moment for it. Because obviously at the moment it only gets done once per stream and it's really rant and some yeah and it might be better if everyone can just sort of feel like they can have a go at using it instead of it being a race to whoever has enough points first. energy. Yeah, Kara, but I don't think that's really a sort of terrible per se. Like, not everyone has the perfect sense of timing. Okay. Access to Magmar's Cavern South granted. Okay. Oh, this is where the, shortcut was, now remember. Well, you don't really need to know exactly when to use it. Just sort of like, oh yeah, I remember. I think that's inside. Yep, this gives me a nice little save point. Do that. Yeah, basically just choose it when there's a boss or when there's a particularly frantic moment and your quid's in. And to be fair, just when I was getting back into the Phazon mines was actually a fairly good choice to torture me, so you knew what you were doing. Let's just get my health back. Unfortunately for me, he knows a lot about this game. But fortunately, he's been eating. Oh yep, so have you finished it then, Ridley? What have you been eating? The missiles following me through there. Yep. Right then. Ooh, baked potatoes with lentils and veg. Nice. Out of interest, what did everyone have for dinner today? Just before I streamed, I had stir fry with beef, noodles, yellow pepper, and mushrooms, and I used a just eat breakfast, Roy. How did Twitch bring up what emotes? since Froy's here, it's time for that part of the stream. So, since I can do it, what I'm going to do is... I'm going to start a prediction. Okay, 1 minute to decide. Will it last 10 seconds, or will it last... less than 10... more than 10 seconds or less than 10 seconds? Place your votes now. Still no votes placed. Okay, we have a vote for 10 seconds. Less than 10 seconds, rather. Oh, several votes for more than 10 seconds. Okay, submissions are closed. So there's only one thing to do. Apart from drop my controller. Okay, and that's 25... 10... 30... That's right, Froy, TSMR. And that lasted for 12 seconds. Unlucky, Kara, unlucky. I'm sure you'll have your chance. Anyway. Goofing around, so let's get to through these lines. Gender neutral, of course. Oh, you put 40k into one in another channel, and that paid off. To be fair. That is pretty well predicted. So. Let's just get through the rest of this then. They're very weak to ice. Which makes sense because they have no chill. Okay, good luck, Kara. I hope your run goes well. Thanks as always for dropping by. And I hope you have a very pleasant evening indeed. Zones are crazy. Okay, let's just recombobulate myself. Omega research. Oh good, there's a save point just ahead. Elite pirate. Phazon enhanced space pirates, incredibly strong, armored and well armed. Elite pirates opposing foes. Their energy cycle systems absorb beam weapon shots. The nature of this system makes them vulnerable to concussion-based weapons. Well armed, the elite pirate is effective in close combat and distance. Aside from the elite, sluggish speeds are okay. Phazon, as it turns out, is one hell of a drug. Okay, so to the right is a save point, thankfully. And we're at the save point, and the rest of the mines is just ahead. Okay. have a cave troll. Well, to be fair, they have Kraid, but he isn't in this game. What's true? Wait, what are you but wearing at? Ridley? Alright. Yeah, I suppose it's not a very nice thing to say, but you know what? He has it coming. Where am I now? Metroid Quarantine. The last area before I had to turn back. Okay. And that's all for that now. Get off me. I know you're being beat, but... create dating sim. The what? I expected the trick here to be I expected the trick here to be grapple beam, but no, it's platforming with the X-ray visor. That's fair enough. I mean, that's a crazy premise, but how is it? Yeah, I've done the entire Twitter thread on the way that you can actually see the gestures Samus is using, because obviously if you look down there, you can see the beams and selecting icons are actually hand gestures, which actually sort of implies she's shooting people like this with the power beam, like this with the plasma beam, like this with the wave beam. And she's doing a Spider-Man hand with the ice beam. This is actually quite difficult to... Am I going the right way? Yes. I did not think that through. Super aggressive cutting the power here now. Although, to be fair, I wonder how the floating invisible platform things are working. And the doors. Hello? How do I get to you then, my friend? Looks like I'm going to get that upgrade or die trying. Roy, thanks for dropping by. I hope you have a nice evening. Okay. Ow. Okay, the X-ray vase is a nice idea, but it really is a pain in the ass to see anything. Bendesium within wall is unstable. Okay. Okay. After all this better be out of the way. I hope there's a save point ahead. Because there's no way in heck I'm doing that again. Access to Phazon Mines level 3 granted. Please step into the hologram. Yep, Steam just informed me that Heaven's Vault is on sale. And I approve. Because I've been meaning to try that out for a while. This friend. A new creature's entry has been valid downloaded to your logbook. Morphology, Hunter Metroid, Adolescent Metroid, Energy Siphon Tentacle increases its threat level. As Metroids develop, they become more efficient predators. As an energy-draining attack allows them to attack at a distance, quick to anger, a Hunter Metroid will charge troublesome prey and ram them into submission. Cold-based attacks are still quite effective against these creatures, and here I am using the Alpha Beam Lucky Bones. Yes, yes, they are. Ow. Okay, can't get up that one. Okay, so I need to get to the top of the room somehow. I guess that means I have to jump on the mushrooms. Yes, I believe you. There's a highly mobile Phazon source. I'm headed to it. Bars again. High levels of Bendesium. About how many morph ball bombs you actually need to get through the through that yet. There's a save point nearby because I'm in serious trouble right now. Oh good, that looks save pointy. So the rest of the area is this way. I'm gonna guess that's a save point to the head. At least I hope it's a save point. Here's the save point. location. I suppose that's good too. But I really would like a save point. Am I going to come out here in the Metroid Ravine? Oh good, they're still not here anymore. Some of these mini grapplets, so cute. I know what prediction. I know what I can use as a prediction here. Okay, place your bet, folks. Will I make it to the save point? Remember, if you guess correctly, you'll win all the losing options, channel points. No takers. Come on, step right up, step right up. I keep missing that mushroom. That's a rare sentence. as a strategy. No. Is there? Nope. Okay, I get the idea of making platform you have to be a bit more precise on, but these mushrooms are actually quite annoying. Okay, any takers yet? Okay, no voters yet. Remember, you've got 5 more minutes to vote on whether or not I'm going to live or die. Where you'd want to do it. Okay, made it through there. Okay, so right at the end of this area is what I hope is a save point. But in any case... Oh, hey, Nerlis. Oh, thanks for your, having faith in me, Nerlis. Also, welcome. Although I'm not sure you'll win anything anyway, because it looks like no one's actually voting. How are you doing this evening, anyway? Lockdown in effect. Hey there. I wonder what they're supposed to do. Oh, there's some waving parts. All right, is it? Hang on, I'll just see if I can. Oh, looks like I'll just scan these. Mega pirate absorption system test results are in. Field tests indicate that the system is very effective against beam weaponry. We are alarmed at the field's inability to handle missile attacks, however. Sans team is working around the clock to correct this critical design flaw. The Omega Pirate cannot afford such a weakness in battle. Okay. Oh, the prediction's closed with 200 points in the pool. They suggest that Omega Pirate lifespans are critically low. High levels of Phazon exposure are causing rapid cell degeneration in all test subjects. No subjects live longer than 2 decacycles in our simulations. Their lifespans must be increased to be cost effective. Okay, and that's some more pirate lore. Okay, that's should have increased the volume of the game slightly. Oh, hey Jenny. Thanks very much for hosting. How are you doing this evening? I'm just about to read out this space pirate lore. Log 11369, nice, 4. As we continue to observe the development of Project Helix's elite pirates, it becomes increasingly obvious that these warriors will usher in a new era of space pirate dominance. They are incredibly resistant to damage, and their ability to transport and wield so many weapons at once makes them the ideal mainstays of our ground forces. Though they are not as quick as typical pirates, it makes little difference with a platoon of elite pirates in the vanguard of an army of normal and flying pirates. We will have an indestructible backbone that should turn the tide in any engagement. Oh. About to have a shower so you can go to physical therapy. That's fair. I hope it all goes well. Thanks for dropping by. Are you going to be watching? Or are you just literally just saying hi? Okay, so I made it to the save point without dying. Oh, that means well, thanks everyone who voted for your faith. Although I'm not sure you're actually going to win anything. Ah, oh, fair enough. Well, it's good to have you here in spirit. Okay, so we're about to fight the Omega Pirate. So let's just do another prediction. This prediction will be, will I beat... Okay, I'm just going to give you all 15 minutes to get your votes in. Okay, so yep, 15 minutes to vote on there. Do you think I'll be beating this boss first time or not? Keep in mind, back when I played this game as a kid, I actually was using a Game Shark at this point, and I can't actually quite remember how to beat the Elite Pirate, so... Yep. Well, someone's put 1.1k on yes. I admire your faith. Phazon processing efficiency at maximum. Production at 187% and rising. Health alert. Phazon radiation warning is still in effect. Do not enter a Phazon processing area without level B... Is that level B or level 8? Radiation gear. Prolonged exposure is 100% fatal. Not 50% fatal. Not 0.5% fatal. 100%. Okay, hedging a bit. Security gate bypass unit encased in frigidite shell. Come on, you can just call it ice. Exposure to extreme heat could clear unit and restore function. Okay, I'm just realising this. All these science fictiony names are just normal materials. Is it really necessary to call ice frigidite? I don't know. You know, this actually reminds me of my D&D game on Friday. Because my character actually ended up in a pit fight with the boss, who was actually supposed to be fought by everyone all at once, ambushed outside the fight. And keeping in mind it was an unarmed brawl, and the boss character actually had unarmed fighting, and my character did not. I mean, so yep, level 3 rogue against a CR4 character. Unarmed. Okay. In my defense, to be fair, I did manage to bloody it before I nearly died. Anyway, okay, QWERTY stop. I hope that call goes well. In any case, look at that idle animation. It's so cool. In any case. There's still time left on the timer, I believe. Yep, 11 minutes to go. Oop, and the betting pool is still rising. So let's head on in and see who this guy is. A new creature's entry has been downloaded into your logbook. Morphology, a mega pirate. Oh, fair enough. I guess people are just throwing in more points. Most powerful of the elite pirate forces. A mega pirate can become invisible to normal sight. It is vulnerable when cloaked, as all energy is drawn from defense systems. By exposing itself to Phazon, it can regenerate damaged tissue and organs. Oh, here's Cursedness. Hey Nick, speaking of D&D, the DM is in the house. How are you doing this evening? Considered the pinnacle of the elite pirate program, this enemy should be handled with extreme caution and maximum firepower. Hey there. Oh, I'm playing Metroid Prime. We're just going to see if I can beat this boss on the first try, and if not, I'm going to pull the stream there. And if I can, I'm still going to call the stream there. Hey there. How you doing today? Hey, Goddess Complex, how are you doing? Goddess Complex. There's a betting on whether I'm going to win this fight first time if you want to join in. There's 5 minutes left on that. Well, sorry for everyone who had faith in me there. It looks like Nolus did pretty well out of that. So, yep, well done to everyone who predicted the correct outcome. I believe you win whatever. Yeah, I think you basically get winnings equal to a share of the losing pool. Yeah, well, I just about managed to. Yep, Nolus has won 5.3k there. So well done, Nolus. Looks like everyone else was a fool to trust me with their points. Yeah, so yeah, it's 2 hours and 15 minutes, so I guess I'll call it here. Actually, tell you what, should I give it another go? Do you want to see me try it again, or? Oh, you know what? I'll give it another go. Drop my controller. Yeah. Yeah, I'll give it one more go and I'll start another poll. You have 15 minutes, so start placing your bets. Are they going to break out? Yes, yes they are. Okay then. Let's try this again. Okay, strategy is simple. I just need to blow up the armor, find him. Find him while he's trying to repair it and shoot him. Be simpler. Gotcha. So I'm going to end submissions, and yep, thanks to everyone who believed in me this time. And we now have the Phazon suit. Your suit has been infused with pure Phazon. This corruption prevents damage from Phazon radiation. Doesn't quite say what happened to the space pirates I just killinated, but okay. Alright, I'm just gonna go back to the save point, and that's where I'll call this stream. Ah, that's fair enough, Nolas. Can't be there for everything. Just get down here without dying. Yep, they're all over the place in the mines. Anyway, let's just save you safe. And a large Samus is very cool suit. And on that note, thanks everyone for dropping by. I appreciate you coming. Obviously, I'll be streaming again Wednesday. What else was I going to say? Alright, obviously for the next couple of weeks it's going to be the normal pattern. Metroid Prime Monday, Wednesday, and there'll be more Phoenix Fries on Friday. But in addition, a week this Thursday, so that's the 17th, I'll be joining Ridley on his channel, where he's going to be hate streaming Metroid Other M, which you may or may not have heard of. I will be making the experiences even worse by tormenting him with puns. I hope you'll all be able to go there. Oh, and it's great to have you here. Congratulations on winning those 700 breadcrumbs. Anyway, who can we raid? Okay. Has anyone got any raid suggestions? Because no one in particular I know seems to be live at the moment. No suggestions. Ah, that's fair enough then. Okay, haven't seen the Blakery for a while. I guess I'll raid them. Okay, so the Blakery, I can't remember how they're connected, but they're connected in some way to the Twitter account known as Bad RPG Ideas. So let's give them a raid. Yeah, it's weird. Normally on Mondays there is at least someone streaming. I guess everyone's busy with Christmas stuff. Well, anyway, in summary, I'll be back again on Wednesday. It's more Phoenix Rise on Friday, more Metroid on Monday and Wednesday next week, and then on the Thursday, I'll be joining Ridley's stream. And then, of course, there'll be more Phoenix Wright on that Friday. Yeah, I hope it does. It will. Roasting the hell out of Other M will be a time. But for today, that's the end of it all. So see you Wednesday when I'll... well, I'll basically be tracking down all of the artifacts and entering the final area. You can probably expect... Oh, I need to create a poll for what to play next. But, yep, aside from that, thanks everyone for coming. It's always great having you here. Thanks to everyone who interacted with points and took part in the votes. And we'll be raiding in three. Well, looks like the time's nearly done, so... let's go. For those watching the YouTube recording, the channel I rated seems to have just gone quiet, so oh well.